elaborate on what Article is talking about. So, how is there a oneness between Ishvara and the Jiva, and what is this oneness? How can it be that what appears as infinite and what appears as finite has a is the same? First, let's look at what exactly the Jiva is and what exactly the Ishvara is. So, first, what is Jiva? Under the influence of Maya, the Maya which causes our ignorance, the consciousness identified with only one equipment is Jiva. Thus, we can say Jiva is consciousness plus individual BMI. The Jiva identifies with only one individual, and so because of this, a sense of difference arises, that you, I am different from you, or I am different from the universe, and so on. Everybody thinks that they are separate from one another because they don't realize that they are under the influence of Maya, and this Maya is making them forget the true identity, which is consciousness. And because of this ignorance, which is called avidya, we are all identifying with our limited equipment, our limited equipment being our individual BMI, and we forget that our true nature, or we don't realize that our true nature is that of consciousness. It conditions us to live under the influence of Maya, and we all believe that we are limited. And this gives rise to the ego or jiva bhav, which gives us the feeling of I and mine, and this causes the misery that of why we don't realize our true nature. Now we move on to what is Ishvara. Ishvara is an identity assumed by Brahman for the purpose of the creation. So it can be described as Brahman with the power of Maya. Ishvara is thus equal to Brahman plus Maya. Ishvara only uses Maya and is never under the influence of it. Using this power, Ishvara is the creator, destroyer and sustainer of the world. Because Ishvara only uses the power of Maya, it is the total BMI, as everything in this world of things and beings is because of the Maya. So we can say that Ishvara is consciousness plus total BMI. So in conclusion, Ishvara is the consciousness with the conditioning of Maya, and Jiva is the consciousness under the influence of Maya. So we'll look at this with an analogy to understand it better. If we imagine many differently colored and sized buckets of water that are all just lying there, and the sun is reflecting in each of them. The water in each is of a different quality. If the sun is Brahman, any reflection of it in the water that thinks of itself as different from the sun and believes only its own identity to be the absolute identity is the Jiva. Each thinks that it is real, not realizing that the reflection cannot be without the sun. The bucket in which the water is like the gross body with which the Jiva identifies and limits itself. In the limits of the bucket, the reflection of the sun is also limited, which makes us think that we are limited. The water is the subtle and causal body. The sun's reflection in only one bucket is the Jiva. And in all the buckets, with the power of the infinite light of the sun, it is the Ishvara, which is the total BMI consciousness. Now, if the water quality in all the buckets is different, okay, the reflection will also be different. For example, if the water is muddy, the reflection might not be as clear. Does this mean that the sun's reflection is dirty? No. It means that the equipment in which the sun is reflecting is dirty or impure. Thus, the visibility of Brahman or the truth is not dependent on the sun, but it is dependent on the quality of the equipment, of the Jiva. In this way, although the consciousness or light of the sun is the same in each reflection, the equipment of the Jiva is different. The sun can never become dirty, the reflection can only appear dirty because of the water. Similarly, the consciousness is changeless, and only the quality of the reflecting medium changes the appearance of the reflection in each of us. Which means that the purer, calmer or cleaner the mind is, the greater is the visibility of divinity in the mind. So now, having understood what Jiva is and what Ishvara is, let us see the relationship between the two. Going back to the equations, Jiva is Brahman plus individual BMI, and Ishvara is Brahman plus total BMI. Ishvara's nature is that of Brahman and so is that of Jiva. Thus, the only difference between the two is in the equipment. While the Jiva identifies with one equipment, मतलब ईश्वरा आइडेंटिफाइज विद ऑल द इक्विपमेंट. सो एज लॉन्ग एज आई आइडेंटिफाई विद ओनली वन इक्विपमेंट आई एम अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ माया एंड आई डोंट रियलाइज दैट आई एम द सेम एज ईश्वरा. सिमिलरली द नेचर ऑफ द जगत दैट इज द वर्ल्ड इज ऑल्सो ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस. इट इज नथिंग बट ब्रह्मन वील्डिंग द पावर ऑफ माया टू प्रोजेक्ट द वर्ल्ड. दस जीवा जगत एंड ईश्वरा आर ऑल ऑफ द सेम नेचर दैट इज ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस ऑफ ब्रह्मन. And from this perspective, they are the same. None of them would exist without consciousness. So how is the oneness between Jiva and Ishwara achieved? When one withdraws completely from the BMI and the ego or the Jiva bhav is dropped in the state of contemplation or deep meditation. In such a state, there is no individuality, so there can be no totality. That means there is no individual BMI and there can be no total BMI. So by the mathematical equations also, Jiva is equal to Ishwara. The duality drops and avidya is no longer binding the Jiva to identify with only its own equipment. This oneness is because of consciousness and not from the body standpoint. The power of Jiva and Ishwara is not the same, just like the wave and the ocean are not the same, but the water in each is the same. Similarly, the consciousness is the same in Jiva and Ishwara, and it is that which makes us the same. If we say that Ishwara is infinite and Jiva is finite, then the infinite can never become finite or the finite can never become the infinite. So this is an imagined difference between the Jiva and Ishwara. The consciousness or the truth which is there in both is infinite. Only the BMI or the equipment with which the Jiva identifies with is finite. This is what the statement of Mahavakya Tattvamasi states. The essential oneness between the Jiva, Jagat and Ishwara. It translates to that thou art and it indicates that Jiva is equal to consciousness that is free from the conditioning of avidya, which means once we have dropped the ignorance, then we realize our true nature. Clear thinking and contemplation over this statement, Tattvamasi, when one has withdrawn fully, one realizes that Jiva and Ishwara are the same. This is the state of Samadhi. Here there is no false identification with the BMI and the BMI is dropped and one realizes that the consciousness in me, in Ishwara, in all the people around me, everywhere, it is the same. Until this is not realized, the person remains stuck in the cycle of birth and death. A person who experiences this is called a Jiva Mukta, which Mukesh will call this.